Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and today Apple released iOS 14.7 Beta 4. This is available to developers and hopefully soon to public beta testers. Usually by the time I post this video, it's live to public beta testers, but sometimes it will take a day or so. As long as it's stable, I would expect it soon though. Now this came in at 273.3 megabytes, that's on my iPhone 12 Pro Max. It was also a couple hundred megabytes on the iPhone 7 and the iPhone XR. Along with this, Apple also released iPadOS 14.7 Beta 4 that I have on my iPad Air 2, also watchOS 7.6 Beta 4, tvOS 14.7 Beta 4, and macOS Big Sur 11.5 Beta 4. All of those are available right now to developers. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the build number and talk about what's new. So we'll go to settings, then we'll go down to general, then about. Now if we tap on the version number, you can see the build number and it's 18G5052D. Now the letter is actually one step backward as we had a C before, but generally as we get closer to a public release, we'll get down to the letter A. So the number is newer, but the letter went back. That's pretty typical though as they continue to update the software. So that means we could have a couple more versions before a final release, although they have been known to jump right to a release candidate and a final version. So we'll have to wait and see what they do with that. Now, as far as anything new, well, on the iPhone 12 Pro Max or the iPhone 12 series, we do get a new modem firmware update. It's not available on everything, and it's fairly small. It went from 1.80.0 to 1.80.01. So if you were having connectivity issues with 5G to 4G switching or anything like that, hopefully it helps, but it was just a small update there. Now, as far as anything new, well, the first thing is they announced today international watch bands to go along with the Olympics. So you can see here on Apple's news website, it says colorful Apple Watch international collection bands and faces help show love of country. So as you can see here, there's different ones you can scroll through and the bands are available now so you can support your country throughout the Olympics. I'm assuming that's why they made these available, but it says Japan, Mexico, and Netherlands. You've got New Zealand, Russia, and South Africa. You've got all sorts of different ones, South Korea, Spain, Sweden, and you can see them here. I'll link this in the description below. If you want to see all of the different ones, you can just cycle through here and take a look at them at Apple's newsroom. Now, as far as new features, well, I did see a new splash screen when I opened up Reminders, for example. So the first time I went into Reminders, I got a splash screen and you can see this here. This is different than the splash screen I had on previous versions. So they've changed it. It just says sort reminders by title, due date, and more, and then print your list. Now it's easy to print lists and take them with you. So I saw this splash screen on the devices I've updated, and the XR was actually on beta 3. I opened up Reminders and it had a different splash screen. So they've changed it just a little bit. Also, with beta 3, they updated podcasts a little bit. And again, I saw a new splash screen. So when I went into library, there was a splash screen similar to that on iOS 15 beta 2. I took a screenshot of it, but let me go on the iPhone 7 and show you here. If we go into podcasts, go to library, you'll see it pops right up. There's a new splash screen talking about shows, saved, and latest episodes. Now, another small change in podcasts, you can see the edit button in my left hand here. In the upper right of the iPhone XR, it says edit. On the iPhone 12 Pro Max on beta 4, there's three little dots. So you have three dots there instead. If I go into shows, for example, it stays the same. It says edit instead of three dots. So they've updated it to a three dot menu. Everything else looks the same for me from beta 3 on the left to beta 4. So I haven't found anything else different there. Now I did have another splash screen pop up in music and I took a screenshot of that. So let's go ahead and take a look. It popped up with this notice saying spatial audio on Apple Music. Now I knew I already had this, but I hadn't seen this before. Whether or not this is showing on iOS 15 betas or not, I'm not sure, but I haven't seen it and it popped up on 14.7 beta 4. So it looked like that and then brought me to the page I just showed you a moment ago. So it talks about spatial audio and more. So it's not available in all countries yet, but that was something new that I saw that popped up. Now, as far as any other features and changes, well, this is a fairly late beta and we know what's in iOS 15. So there's not any other huge feature changes that I was able to find so far. However, there is resolved or known issues still in this beta. Now, for those of you that are new to betas, or maybe you just weren't aware, if you go into the feedback app, every time they post their notes with known issues and more. So if you go into the feedback app, you can see there's a resolved issue here and it says restored battery service messages that may have disappeared after a reboot on some iPhone 11 models. So the message may not have been there, now it is. And then there's a known issue for developers if they're using this specific API or callout. So you can see that here. So those are what's in this specific beta. That's pretty small as far as the notes go. Sometimes the notes go on and on and on, such as iOS 15, for example. So in this particular update, there's not a whole lot new as far as that goes, but it's nice to see them getting it refined. And as far as things such as resolved issues with green tint, well, so far no one's messaged me saying that it's still there, but that doesn't mean they haven't done anything with it or have even fixed it. We don't know yet. It takes a few days generally for people to message me and say, hey, green tint is still there, but most of those issues have gone away. A few people have said it's there with iOS 15, for example, but for the most part, it's doing pretty well as far as that goes for most people's phones. If it's very severe at this point, maybe you want to talk to Apple about it. However, last year they fixed it with iOS 13 late in August. So it's definitely something they could be working on still. Now, as far as iPadOS, well, you get the same changes and the same sort of splash screens I shared with you before. If I go into reminders, you can see it there. There's a splash screen there. And again, the same thing as in podcasts. I don't know that I have podcasts installed on this iPad, but the same thing is in podcasts as well. So those splash screens are there. Nothing really particularly new or exciting with iPadOS 14.7. The big changes come with 15, and that wasn't as big as some people had hoped, but there are new changes such as widgets and things, and most of the older devices still get a lot of those features. Not everything, but quite a few of them. Now, as far as battery life overall, well, I've been using iOS 15 full-time, but I wanted to share with you someone that's been using with it 14 full-time that sent me some screenshots from their device. So let's go ahead and take a look at those. So Cameron sent me a couple screenshots from his iPhone 12 Pro Max running iOS 14.7 beta 3 and now beta 4. And you can see this was his screen on time, 2 hours and 8 minutes of screen on time, 1 hour and 15 minutes of screen off time. And he used about 20% of his battery. This graph is going up to 120%. For some reason, but he did use that. If we go over to the next page, again, similarly for the day before, 2 hours and 49 minutes, 2 hours and 55 minutes of screen off time. And again, the previous day where he used 80% of his battery, he got 6 hours and 50 minutes of screen on time and 2 hours and 1 minute of screen off time. That's pretty good usage overall, meaning that he probably is getting 8 to 10 hours of screen on time if you were to extrapolate that out. So meaning that you used your phone the entire amount up to 100% of its full usage. So that's pretty good battery life in 14.7, especially compared to many complaining about 14.6. Now, as far as performance overall, well, you saw it a little bit on the iPhone 7. This is the oldest iPhone that I have in this video anyway. And as you can see, it's performing okay. There's a little bit of stutter as I go into music and everything's loading in the background. That's to be expected as it's loading. But as far as an OS overall, scrolling through, it's really not any different than the previous beta as far as speed in my experience so far. The little time that it's been out, you can see here, it's a little stuttery in music for some reason. If I go into music on the other devices here, scroll down, it's fairly smooth. So on the 7, it's loading a little bit slow, and that may be a problem as far as that goes. But right now, maybe it'll speed up as we let it go on. So it seems a little bit faster now as everything's loaded. But in general, I wouldn't expect the performance to change much. At this point, it might be a little bit better. But let's take a look at the Geekbench scores. So if we go into Geekbench, I did run it on the 12 Pro Max and the 7 and the iPad Air 2 like I did before. And you can see I scored 1,598 for single core, 4,166 for multi-core. I did not run this multiple times. If we take a look at CPU here for history, we'll go into June 29th and you'll see before, it was a little bit slower for single core and a little bit faster for multi-core. Now, considering this was the first time I ran this, that's not bad. It's probably pretty fast and will improve over the next day or so as it continues doing things in the background, such as indexing, and it finishes those. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the other devices. Now on the left is the iPad Air 2, in the middle is the iPhone 7, and on the right is the iPhone 12 Pro Max. This should just give you a general idea of what to expect right after installing the beta. These numbers can improve and often do after a few days. So give it a couple days, run it again. But if they're anywhere in the general area of these benchmarks, your speed should be about the same as before. So it's to give you a general overview of what's going on. Now, as far as when to expect iOS 14.7 beta 5 or release candidate, I would expect them, based on being this late in the betas, to be on a weekly schedule. And now that we have iOS 15 beta 2 out, along with iOS 14.7 beta 4. I would expect beta 5 to be on a weekly schedule until it releases to the public. That's generally what they do. Again, they could change this like they did with beta 3 to beta 4, for example. So maybe in a few weeks we'll have a public release of 14.7 and then 14.8 maybe until the release of iOS 15 in September. Now, as far as iOS 15 and the public beta, if iOS 15 beta 2 is stable enough, I would expect it maybe as soon as Thursday, since they said it would be coming in July. A lot of people have been asking me that, so we could see it as soon as Thursday or Friday, or it could be the following week where maybe we expect them to release iOS 15 beta 3. So it just depends on how stable they find it and what time frame Apple has, but they haven't told anyone when it's coming out yet, so we still have to wait for that. Now, as far as iOS 15 betas, I would typically wait until the public beta is available to make sure that you're on a more stable build and you can use it from day to day, since a lot of people put it on their main device. It's been pretty good on my main device. I've been using it on a 12 Pro Max. It's been pretty good, but it still has some bugs here and there. So wait for the public beta with that if you're not already on the betas. And so that's everything in iOS 14.7. Of course, we could see 14.8 by the time 15 is released, but we'll have to wait and see what they do. Now, if I find anything else new, of course, I'll keep you updated with a follow-up later this week. And if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already, though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.